Let's do the raspberry and chocolate mousse cake now.
No, sorry about that. In case you didn't understand, we're gonna make a raspberry and chocolate mousse cake, layered with almond macaroons biscuits. Beautiful. Great combination. So we're gonna start to do our almond biscuits. And we're gonna need a raspberry puree to make the raspberry mousse. So we've got some broken raspberry frozen. It's just broken. So we're gonna make it with it. The recipe, it's 750. Right, we're gonna make 750. 375. Okay, 450 gram of raspberry, broken piece, and 10% of sugar. So 450 will be 45 gram. Yeah, that's it. Mix it together in a pan. And then a little dash of water. Like that. And we're gonna let it cook. Gonna let it cook. And then we're gonna have to sieve it to remove all the pippins, little seeds. And voila, we're gonna have our raspberry puree. That will be the base of our raspberry mousse. So for now, almond macaron biscuits, which we need 240 gram of ground almond, 240 gram icing sugar, egg white, 375 gram of egg white, which I get now. Right, that's all the leftover egg white we are keeping, you know. Can do meringues or biscuits. Yeah, well, I go slightly over, but it's fine. So we need to whisk it. And for that, we need some caster sugar too. To whip the egg white, so it's gonna be a French meringue, as we say. No, I need 190. That's it. Okay, let's whip it. Icing sugar sieve again, because it's got like little pieces, but you want something very thin. So we sieve the icing sugar. There you go. The ground almond on top. Let's check our egg whites. So we're gonna pour the caster sugar gently. I'll tell you when, not yet. We'll be faster by hand. No, I don't think so. Look at that, it's jumping! Okay, now you see? It starts to go quite white. It's quite white, foamy. Let's put a little bit of sugar. It's gonna make a meringue, a firm meringue, you know, strong meringue, if you add the sugar slowly. A little bit more. All sugars in now. And look at that, the tiny version. Yes, nearly ready. It's ready. When you got that little design of a whisking thing, yeah? See, very firm. Okay. Need the Maries. In there. I'm gonna put icing sugar and ground almond in there. Yeah. Let's put a little bit to start. Would be nice to have someone to help at this stage. Because time someone's pouring it, you mixing it, it will be much faster. I put a little bit more. So yeah, it's kind of macarons, you know? A biscuit, so it's gonna be a quite sticky in the middle, but so crunchy on the outside. It's fantastic, and even layered with mousses, it's not gonna get damp. It's gonna stay crunchy in the middle of your mousses. It's beautiful biscuits. Make sure everything's mixed. There you go. Lovely, Anna. Right, we need to pipe it. Pipe it is better because you are keeping the hair into your meringue. If you're gonna use a palette knife, it's gonna lose all your hair. Air. It would be not good to using a palette knife. Raspberries boiling. We reduce a bit the fire, I will say, but it's electric stove. Just put it low. Okay. That's done. Palette knife. I'm using a nozzle. It's up to you, nozzle, no nozzle. Scissors. Okay. Clean tray. Right. Into your piping bag. It's gonna take quite a long time to cook this one. Usually it's about 20 to 25 minutes. So because we're gonna use, I think a round shape to make this cake, a round ring, let's do a snail biscuit. That size, yes, that should be enough. Yeah, that should do, no? In the oven, 170. 170. And let's put the timer first of all for 20 minutes and we see how it goes. Right. Now we're gonna check our raspberry. It's ready to be mixed. Right. So we're gonna transfer it in a smaller container. Oh, it smells gorgeous. Oh, it's fine. Back to that same pan. Doesn't matter if you still have little pippins in there. It'll give a little crunchy in your mousse. Right. Receive it. Don't make it too liquid, so you know, if it's too liquid, too much, if you did add too much water from the beginning, let it reduce down a little bit, you know, let it reduce. You need to have a kind of a fruit puree consistency. This one seems to be a bit too liquid, so we're gonna have to reduce. That's fine. Right? So that. Now it's all passed through to the sieve. So this one, bye-bye. And here you got quite a thick fruit puree, right? See, you glaze your finger when you put your finger in. Yeah, so that will be enough to make our raspberry mousse. Right, okay, so we're gonna make our raspberry mousse with our raspberry puree made with raspberry, frozen raspberry. Nice, very nice. We're gonna start to do, then we need to whip some cream, we need Italian meringue, and we need to get this raspberry puree mixed with some gelatins. So it's quite lots of things going on. Let's start to whip the whipping cream. We need 600 grams. Okay, 600 grams, or should we do, no, let's do a bit less, let's do 300 grams, sorry, no, yeah, okay. So we're gonna whip that Until it's whipping, we're gonna prepare the Italian meringue. Which is... So we're gonna need some caster sugar. One ten, 200 gram of caster sugar. Yeah. 1/3 of the water, so that will be around 70 gram. Yeah. And this got to boil until 121. When you reach the 115, you start the egg white, whisking the egg white at 115 degrees. And time the egg whites whipping, your sugar syrup going up, up, up in temperature. 121 the sugar syrup. Whip the egg white, it will be quite whipped, ready to pour into it. But you're gonna see it. Okay. That's a raspberry puree. We need 375. Okay, keep the leftover to have it with a vanilla ice cream or something, a yogurt or whatever. Okay, so that's fine. From your 375 gram, you're gonna keep some in the fridge because some of it we're gonna heat it up to melt the gelatin in there, and then from the cold puree add it to it to let it set together. Okay. Right, so that the whipping cream is nearly ready. Okay, that's ready. Take it out from your bowl. Okay, we're gonna leave the keep the bowl for to whip the egg white now. But this time we have to clean it very well because the grease of the cream doesn't work with the egg white. Egg white's got to be whipped in a very super clean dish. All right. So now we're gonna wait it up our egg white. Because we've got 200 of caster sugar, we need half of the quantity of the sugar as egg white. So 100 gram. Wait. So do you remember we start to whisk it when the sugar did reach 114 or 115. Which is not gonna be long now because it's 109. So it's got to be precise, huh? See, that's whipped already. So it's ready to pour the sugar. 121. There you go. Oh, Okay. Reduce the speed and now we let it whip and cool it down gently. You don't need to whisk it full power to cool it down. It's not necessary. Just gentle. Now we need some gelatin for our raspberry puree. So we're gonna use 5.5 leaves. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five and a half in a cold water to make it soft. Right. Because the fridge is not cold enough, I'm gonna stick it in the freezer just for cool it down very well. Okay. Gelatin's ready. And we're gonna stick it into the warm raspberry. Melt it down. Okay, that's melt. And we are waiting our cold puree to cool it down. So let's wait a little bit. Together. All right. So now we're gonna lay our biscuits, the first layer biscuits, into our ring. Look at biscuit, beautiful, very well done. Right. Let's use the same parchment, no waste. A ring better already. Or you can always do this little recipe in a verrine. You know the little clear glass? And you layered it into a glass and you make a lovely dessert. So I put a bit of acetate to don't make it too sticky. I have to cut the biscuit at the right size of my circle, of my disc, sorry. Voilà. Do the same one, time you're here, you do the other one too. Right? There you go. Like that? Little test. Great. Right, the meringue, the bottom is cold. So it's done, it's ready. We're gonna mix it with the whipping cream. So this two things together. Right. the puree with the gelatin has got to be cooled down now with the cold one. Maris. So yeah, it's very cold, it's great. It's gonna set, make the gelatin work a bit. Right, that's done. And now a bit of whipping cream meringue into your raspberry gelatin. So you can do exactly the same recipe with any fruit. Okay, back into the big bowl. Beautiful. Okay. Bring some lightness again. Voilà. Yeah. Okay, so now we're gonna just finish the touches of the raspberry and chocolate mousse cake. So I did keep some left over of the dark chocolate mousse we made for the Black Forest gâteau. So you can catch the recipe in this precedent episode. I did put my raspberry mousse into the fridge, let it set a little bit. And now we're just gonna layer it with those lovely biscuits. Piping bag again. Okay. So the dark chocolate mousse and the raspberry, it goes very well together, especially with a lovely almond sweet flavor in. Oh, it's great. Lovely cake. All right. Voilà. The other biscuits. Missing that little piece. Let's use a bit of trimming if you're missing some biscuits. There. Press it down a bit. Lovely. Okay. I just lift up a bit the plastic to leave some space for raspberry mousse, right? Okay. And now, the pink coming. Just move it, yeah. Voilà. All right. So this is a raspberry and chocolate mousse cake. All set. It's been in the fridge. It's lovely. Let's put a board underneath. We're gonna remove the acetate. Where's the gun? Yoo-hoo. Here he is. Right. There you go.